Welcome to High Top Sports Network. My name is Joe Roach. Joining me this evening, Armstrong, River Rocks left fielder, Jenna Clontz. Jenna, welcome.
Thank you.
I have to start, you're probably not tired of talking about it, but I have to start with the home run. The home run. It's always going to be known as the home run. I've never actually got to talk to you about it. Can you think of a better script? Can you think of a better way a part of your story to be than that home run? Is there anything better than that?
No, there really isn't. And that's really all I get now is, oh, you're the girl that hit that walk-off home run. I'm like, yeah.
Well, I think it's pretty fair to say that that's not the only part of your game that's noticeable. Obviously, you're getting the recognition and the accolades deserving of your play, not just that one home run. Talk about your game. You're a very diverse player. I feel like, you know, coaches, and going back to last year with Coach Flanders, not afraid to ask you to put down a bunt at certain times, and do those things to execute to win the game. Be a sure-handed left fielder like you are. How important is it for you to be well-rounded, to not just focus on the hitting part of the game, which you obviously excel at, but, you know, just every little facet of the game that makes you who you are?
I think my fielding game has definitely, like, been crucial since we know we're playing these really good teams. And trying to keep the ball in the ballpark, I think it's super important that, like, my fielding has gotten better, which I do pride myself in my fielding a little bit, but obviously my hitting is a little bit better than my fielding. But yeah, definitely my spot in left field, you can ask him, is definitely real crucial. And, you know, I've been trying to work on that a little bit more than my hitting.
Yeah, you're obviously well seasoned. You've played in a lot of big games. You've got to play on the biggest stage the state has to offer twice. Why do you feel like this team's different? Even compared not just to last year, but the year prior to when you guys played Lampeter-Strasburg in the state championship game, you know, how would you differentiate this particular team maybe from those two?
I think we're more experienced. You know, we have most of our core girls back this year. So having that chemistry this year and the experience will definitely help us excel more this year than in the past. Obviously last year we saw greater results rather than the first year, because, you know, we've been there before, and, you know, coming back a third year with, you know, most of the same girls, I think that it's going to be even better than it was last year.
Yeah, and it's hard to quantify what experience actually does, because you guys were a little bit experienced going into last year's state championship game, and certainly the Whitfield championship, which you won. And I think that kind of shows what you're talking about, that experience, though it seems like you guys have played enough big games that there's always room to grow, and there's always room to kind of become more experienced, I think.
Yep.
How do you feel like your role's changed? Obviously, you're a senior now. Maybe talk a little bit about how your leadership role maybe and how you kind of display yourself to your team is different now as a senior than even in years past, because obviously you were always counted on prior to your senior year. So how has that maybe changed? How have you noticed it has changed this year?
I think most of my leadership, although I'm very vocal, I lead more by action, and obviously the girls look to me to, you know, get on base and hit the ball. So, like, having that kind of pressure actually kind of helps me a little bit more during games and stuff like that. But after that Whitfield game and the state run last year, I think the girls look up to me a little bit more than last year. So having that senior, you know, role on the team, leadership has definitely been crucial. And, you know, yeah.
How is it that you guys managed to let teams kind of at least make them feel like they're hanging around for so long in a game, and then all of a sudden, you know, with six outs left in the game, you guys decide to drop an eight spot in the scoreboard? What is that? Because it's dating back to last year, and you guys, here you are now, new season, you're still doing it. So what is that? How does that come to be?
I don't know. Our coaches think it's like it takes a couple times through the lineup, you know, get the timing, but these past couple games we've been doing it, and we used to at the beginning of the season last year, we used to jump on them real fast, like teams jump on real fast, and now we're waiting to like the third or fourth inning to start hitting the ball. So I don't know what's going on, but hey, it's working out. So
when you have so many players that have been on a big stage, played in two state championship games, two Whitfield games, you got to find new ways to challenge yourselves, I guess.
Yeah,
and one way to do so is maybe letting teams feel like they're in it for a little bit, and then you find the gas pedal late on in the game, and
giving them false hope.
Yeah, exactly. What do you feel like you noticed that's different just with the mentality? Because I had a chance to talk to obviously Coach Schaefer, talk to Emma as well, Emma Smerick, and what it seemed like the consistent message was you guys know you're hunted. You guys know that people are even looking at you under a microscope more so than even last year. And it's not like you really surprised too many people, being that you were returning state runner-up. This year, though, it seems there's even a bigger target. Do you feel that? Do you notice it? And, you know, is that a heavy load to have to carry?
Yeah, a lot of teams know that we're good and, you know, have the same girls coming back. And having to play the best that we can possibly play every single game is really hard. And knowing that the only team that can beat us is ourselves is definitely a ton of pressure. And I think everyone kind of knows that, you know, Armstrong's good. And, you know, it's kind of like scary going into games sometimes, you know, starting off really slow and thinking like, well, we got to turn it on or, you know, we're not going to know what's going to happen. So, yeah, I think a lot of people, and I especially, can feel that, you know, we're being hunted this
year. Yeah, the thing about you guys, because I had a chance to be at the state championship game this last year, you never feel like you guys are out of it. Even going into those final innings, even though things were pretty stagnant there for most of the game, you could never rule your team out. You know, I think that's very evident with the game prior to it against Penn Trafford. You know, you guys were kind of stagnant at first, but when you needed those hits, you included coming up with a big hit in that game, you were able to do so. So that clutch gene, it seems like it's not just exclusive to you or to, you know, player, you know, B, C, or D. What do you think makes that the case? Is it something that rubs off on each other, or is it just kind of built into each of you?
I think we all trust each other. I know when I go into a game, maybe if I'm not doing good personally, I know that the 8 other girls in the field will take care of business. Right. So I think that just kind of comes with playing with each other for a long time. You know, we kind of trust each other. We trust Cam. We trust Bella behind the plate, and we trust our hitting. So I think when we stick to the fundamentals, you know, I think we, no matter what happens, we get it done.
A team that's accomplished so much is still probably capable, from what you're saying and coaches said and Emma said as well, of finding ways to put a chip on your shoulder still. I remember following you guys 2 years ago in that state playoff run, and the fact you had to travel so far east was a chip on your shoulder. So is that something you guys still find the ability to do as easily, finding these reasons to still have to prove yourselves on a day in and day out basis?
Kinda, you know, it kind of comes with cockiness and confidence. Like, we're not sure, you know, where to lie in between that. You know, we can't just go out and say, oh, we're going to 10 run this team. Like, we got this, like, we've won in the past. Like, you can't really have that, but within, we have to have that kind of confidence. Like, yeah, we're going to go out and 10 run this team. So, I mean, there's certain situations where we have that kind of chip on our shoulders a little bit, but, you know, at this point, we got to stay humble and, you know, kind of ride the wave out, because every season's a different season and we're going to get every single team's best. So, you know, I got to kind of keep it on the low.
You're right. Absolutely. You know, it's interesting to me. I have a chance to talk to a lot of athletes that are, you know, made their college decision, had a lead up to that college decision, similar to yours. And it's always neat to see the different opinions on it. Some people wanted that process over with, and it was a weight off their back. Some, you know, didn't really even notice it. It was just a part of the process. For you, now you're another Gannon commit on this team. Was that something for you that you felt like did give you that weight? So you can maybe just start playing the way that you know how to without having to think too much about, you know, outside things.
Yeah, definitely. I committed super early. I committed in February, and it was kind of good because it was right before high school season started. So, you know, before I committed, I thought that I had to go out and perform like my best every single time, so college coaches would notice that. And, you know, have that, you know, kind of locked up, it released some pressure off of me personally. So knowing that, you know, I'm already committed, like, although maybe I didn't play this good that game, like, I'm still committed and it doesn't matter. You know what I mean? So yeah, I did that on purpose a little bit. I wanted to commit super early. So, you know, I kind of had the season to, you know, focus on the team and focus on that kind of stuff. But yeah, that process was super stressful.
Yeah. I feel like that's sort of the answer I get more often than not, you know, that it is sort of a weight and it can be sort of a tiring process, really. Both mentally and, you know, just physically, because as you said, you're trying to impress coaches, you know, day in and day out. That's just, you know, kind of you having to push yourself to the limit in all ways, really.
Yep.
This season, I think, is unique, obviously, because that core, and this is nothing against the groups prior, the past two graduating classes, because important players resided in both of those. But now that this class that I think people have kind of looked at as having, you know, most starters in it, you know, for the last couple of years, and, you know, really the core residing within this class, Do you guys ever kind of put that, besides being Armstrong and being the hunted, do you ever feel like now, oh, we're seniors, everybody expected us to go as far as we could this year? Do you guys kind of ever feel that and think about that as well?
You know, we're used to having a younger team, and, you know, kind of this year we're like, wow, most of our, you know, varsity is juniors and seniors. So no, I really don't think so. You know, we kind of like, you know, it's kind of good to have an older team. So, you know, the younger girls have something to, you know, look up to and, you know, kind of follow in that. And a lot of younger girls next year are going to have to step up. And, you know, I think our senior class does a great job of leading by example. So I think it's good that most, you know, our team's older and having those seniors, you know, kind of be leaders for the younger groups ahead.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's neat. It kind of segues into my next question for you. Talking to Coach Schaefer, he mentioned that there is a growing interest and an interest that's tangible in softball now that didn't exist before this group, that, you know, you guys have breathed life into softball in the area, and there are girls watching you guys and trying to emulate you and trying to keep that Armstrong tradition intact that you guys have started. How neat is that for you to be a part of that? Obviously being the first Whipple championship team in school history as well. And, you know, eventually if this continues to kind of build momentum, like it seems to be, you know, being a big reason why, you know, when somebody sees Armstrong on their schedule, whether it's today or 10 years from now, knows they're going to get a really good quality team.
It feels good, especially to be the group that, you know, kind of started that tradition. And I know some of the younger girls, like the junior high group, has a really good group coming up, and that's super exciting for, you know, the program and stuff. But yeah, it's super cool. Funny story, a girl moved here from California and she played softball in the past. And one of the girls at my school was like, are you going to come for the softball team? Like, you know, softball is a really big thing here. And just to, like, kind of hear that, like, kind of made me feel good about myself. So yeah, it's super cool.
Yeah, it is. And it's neat from my perspective. I've known Coach Schaefer since he was the assistant the first year the school existed. They were playing down at Judd Field. You guys should be so happy you get to play where you do now, comparatively speaking. But I remember going there, and as Coach would admit, the wins were much fewer. They were leaner years. And to see just the turnaround the program has made, it's been remarkable, really, from where they've been or where they were and where they're at now. And again, your class and this little run is certainly responsible for, I think, those junior high teams you mentioned having the interest that they do. Who on this team do you feel like maybe gets the best out of you? You're probably going to say your coaches, because that's their job. That's what they're the best at doing. But is there somebody or something in that dugout that you feel like sometimes is able to get the most out of Jenna Clontz when maybe, you know, you're tired and you're, you know, late in the season and, you know, looking for reasons to kind of like stay strong? Is there something that that you kind of reach for and go to in that dugout that does that for you?
I wouldn't say any particular thing. I just think, like, maybe like the team as a whole, like when we get really excited in the dugout, like that energy that everybody has, you know, when we're successful at the plate or successful in the field, like having that behind you, and, you know, when you get a big hit and you can hear that excitement in the dugout. Yeah. Like that really gets me going. So it really motivates me, especially when I'm batting, you know, the people cheering in the dugout, like when I get a hit or something and they're going crazy, like that just feels so good to me. So that definitely motivates me, like the energy of the team.
Yeah, it's funny because, you know, it's like the old adage about the Pirates. If you put a good team on the field, the fans will come. And it's neat to see. And it was very evident with you guys. That's the case with that first state playoff game, that, you know, hillside covered, and it looked like a minor league baseball field almost. It was just awesome to see. How does it feel? Are you able to kind of stop and admire that stuff and take it in, but also know that you have a job to do? Are you able to find that balance? Or are you one of those people where, you know, hard hat on, I'm going to work, you know, I'll be able to reflect on it when it's done, but then maybe you're left with a little bit of regret not stopping and kind of looking around a little bit?
After playing in the state in the Whipple games, like you kind of learn how to block that out. But when experiencing that the first time, it was like, wow, like this is not real, especially that state game. Like we still talk about that at practice. Like that was crazy. Like, you ever see that drone picture of like, that is crazy. Like we still talk about that. Like when someone gets a hit, like the whole place erupts. It was crazy. But no, at the end of the day, you kind of have to block out that noise and, you know, kind of get the job done. And we've done that. So I think it comes with experience. You know what I mean? So.
Yeah. I have one more question, then I'm going to, I feel like it'd be unfair to not give you the same opportunity I did Emma, and that was rapid fire. Did she tell you?
She told me about that.
Yes. So you're going to get a little rapid fire too, because I don't think it'd be very fair to Emma if we didn't put you on the, you know, the chopping block a little bit here too. But first I want to ask, you keep alluding to it. Emma alluded to it. Coach Schaefer alluded to it. You've all said the same thing unprompted, meaning I didn't have to ask you. And that is, we are the only thing that can beat us. Beating ourselves is the really only way that we don't reach, you know, where we want to go. Where is that coming from? Is that openly talked about? Or is that just something that everybody's innately felt and is just kind of an unspoken thing between all you guys at this point?
I think over the past couple of years, we've kind of proved ourselves to the public. And even at practice, we still day by day prove to each other that, you know, we're the best. And when people ask, like, oh, who are the teams that, you know, you're kind of looking out for? It's like, no one. Like, we're, you know, we are going to, at the end of the day, if we lose, we beat ourselves. Yeah. Like, if you look at the games that we lost in the past and even the game against Henfield, we beat ourselves. So I think it's just kind of like that self-confidence, you know, kind of, you know, we're the best, but at the end of the day, you know what I mean? Like, we're,
It's interesting though, that been around a lot of teams, a lot of good teams, and you guys certainly quite possibly at the top of that. But I've never seen so much confidence. And sometimes I think that can be a scary thing for teams, you know, trying to display too much confidence and kind of putting, making that target we've talked about even bigger. It seems like you guys kind of aren't necessarily afraid of that.
No, we have confidence usually, like before games, like at practice, but like when it comes to games, like, you know, we mean business. Like, we're not here to mess around, but like we don't openly, like, you know, display that cockiness, you know what I mean? But as a team that was first last year and, you know, made the state run 2 years in a row, like, you kind of have to have that confidence, like, and we still have that group, so it's, you kind of need to have that confidence, like, yeah, we're the number one team in Western Pennsylvania, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely. And you look at all the greats, no matter what it is, any sport, they're all confident. The greats in every sport are confident, and some might call them cocky. Some might call them arrogant, but that's just kind of that edge that you have to, kind of, I think you're alluding to, that you have to have. It goes in with success. So whether or not you're called arrogant or you're called cocky, winning is what matters, you know, and that's something that, again, it seems like you guys aren't afraid to toy with and walk that line. I'm going to name a task. So this is maybe a little bit easier. I'm going to name a task, and you have to pick which teammate you would pick to help you in such task.
Okay.
So this is, I think, easier than what Emma had, because she just, I said one word to describe everybody. That's a lot of pressure.
Yeah.
So at least this one, maybe not as hard, but we'll see. It might be.
Okay.
All right. You have a flat tire. The first person you're calling to change it is?
Emma Paul.
Why?
She's really smart. And I think she's good at critical thinking, you know, fast on the spot, you know what I mean? So I think I'd call him a Paul.
When you get good news, who is the best teammate to share with?
Emma Smerick.
Why?
She's really positive, always giving a great reaction. I'd definitely tell Emma.
Well, that's neat, because you're going to school with two of your teammates, which is, you're a very unique situation, I'm sure. If we went and really scoured to look for teammates graduating from the same class, going to the same school like that. If you could take one more of those teammates with you, who is it?
Cassidy Adams. We'd have the whole outfield at Gannon.
And something tells me you guys feel pretty confident that would translate over to the college game too, as well as it has here in high school.
100%.
You getting your, it's late at night, 1 a.m, let's say. Your phone's ringing. Which teammate is it?
Emma Paul.
am I able to ask why?
She's my best friend. You know, that's probably happened a couple times. But, yeah, we FaceTime pretty much all the time. So that's kind of like a more realistic answer.
Teammate that's most likely to become a millionaire?
Cam Sprinkle.
Why?
I mean, her family, having that family background of that grocery store, and she's going into finance, so I think she's going to do something real big.
Yeah, I know her dad quite well, and, you know, he's a savvy guy, and, you know, obviously a smart man as well, so obviously, you know, everything goes downhill, as they say.
Yep.
Slides downhill. So Cam just absorbing all that stuff from Ryan. If she starts putting out the crazy zany videos, though, we might have to pump the brakes on her, tell her to kind of leave it to her old man.
Yeah, leave it to Ryan.
last one. You can't pick yourself.
Okay.
Yep. There's two outs in the ball game. Same situation, or actually, you had no outs in your situation. Let's use your situation then. No outs, leading off the ninth inning or seventh inning, excuse me. Who would you want in that situation? Let's say if it was two outs, but you need somebody beside you. You can't pick yourself. Who do you put up there, and you need that hit?
Jessie Pugh, 100%. No question about it. She was super clutch last year in the playoffs as well, and you know she comes up with great timely hits.
Yeah, and she definitely was. You and her both, and you know, really just everybody, and you mentioned this, kind of contributed when they needed to. It felt like when they were due to, they would. And that was kind of the unique thing about you guys. And again, it's always nice to be deep and talented like you guys are. And that's certainly big reason why you have a chance to go to three straight PIAA championship games. Man, oh man, I'm trying to think of another good one because you were pretty good at that. You got me pretty quick. So yeah, Emma definitely got the harder end of this. So Jenna, I guess I'm going to leave you with this. Armstrong will not be in the state championship game for a third time if. And you can't say beat yourselves.
If we aren't all in, if we don't, so obviously this year, you know, we had a change in coaching staff and, you know, the dynamic's a little bit different than last year. Although, you know, Schaefer did not invent the wheel. It's still a little different in practices and, you know, the atmosphere is a little different. And I said it and I said it again, like if we're not all in and we're trusting the process, you know, we're not going to get back there. So, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I haven't had a chance to see you guys in an away game. Do you still come off the bus with the boombox blaring, the music just blaring?
Yep. I carry that thing over my shoulder. Full blast.
I was going to say, I'd be a little worried if you guys took that out of the routine because it seemed to work quite well.
Nope,
it didn't matter with the venue. You guys just walked off the bus very confident, music blaring. You weren't afraid to draw attention to yourselves. You backed it up. So it was like clockwork with you guys. You get off the bus and it was just all these moving pieces and you guys just replicated it game after game. It was really cool to see.
Yep.
All right. Well, Jenna, thank you so much for making the time. Appreciate it. Tearing the cover off the ball right now. Keep doing that. And you guys certainly will be making us watch softball the whole way into almost nearly July, it felt like.
Hopefully, yes.
Yep. All right. Best of luck, Jenna. We'll be catching up with you here soon.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was Jenna Clontz from the Armstrong River Rocks, the left fielder senior, the epic home run hitter from that Whitfield Championship game a season ago. That wraps it up for Jenna Clontz. My name is Joe Rhodes. We'll see you next time.